Alright guys, welcome back to this channel. So ever since I put up my last video on me using my KeyLab Essential together with Ableton Live Session View, I got quite a few comments from you guys requesting a quick tutorial on how to set up the integration between KeyLab Essential and Ableton Live Session View. You guys asked for it, so here is it. Actually, the setup is quite simple, but there are a couple of places where things might go wrong, and I will remind you when we get there. So let's begin. First off is to put your KeyLab Essential in DAW control mode, and this can be done by pressing Map Select and press the second pad, which says DAW. And as you may know or may not know, KeyLab Essential has several modes. You have a analog lab mode, which is for control your analog lab plugin, and you have a DAW control mode, which is for control various DAWs. And you also have several user customizable mode. So here we are using the DAW control mode. And next up, let's go to our Ableton Live. And let's bring up Ableton Live's setting. And let's go to the Link Tempo MIDI page. And there, there's a section called MIDI. And you can go to an empty slot. And under Control Surface, you select KeyLab Essential. Be sure to select KeyLab Essential if you are using KeyLab Essential. And if you are using KeyLab Mark II, you also got a separate Control Surface setup here. And for the second slot, you're going to choose Arturia KeyLab Essential DAW In. Be sure to select DAW In. And as you may know or may not know, your KeyLab Essential has two ports. One is a MIDI In, and another is DAW In. So here you're going to choose the DAW In, not MIDI In. A lot of people can't get their KeyLab Essential working in Ableton Live because they accidentally choose the wrong port. So make sure you have DAW In. And for the next slot, you're gonna choose the DAW Out. And by the way, I'm using a 88 key version of KeyLab Essential now, but my previous video was shot with a 61 version of KeyLab Essential. They are pretty much the same thing except for the keypad. As soon as you've selected the correct port in the control surface section, your KeyLab Essential should have DAW Live preset here on this tiny screen. If you don't see DAW Live preset, you only see DAW or anything else, that means your Ableton Live is not set up correctly, and you might just want to go back and check your settings. And here under MIDI ports, actually you don't have to change any of the settings, but let me quickly give you an idea of what is going on here. So there are two ports that corresponds to your KeyLab Essential, as we have mentioned previously. One is this one. This is your MIDI In, which receives MIDI notes from your keyboard. And the second one is a DAW control port, which is for KeyLab to communicate with Ableton Live. And by default, this port has track selected and the rest as selected. What does that mean is that anything that is not recognized by the control surface script will go to your track. What does that mean is for some of the buttons on KeyLab Essential, which is not mapped and not used by Ableton Live's KeyLab Essential script, then that MIDI note will be passed on to your track, which sometimes can produce unintended note trigger. So usually I will uncheck this box. So let's close the preference panel and see what we can do with our KeyLab Essential and how we can interact with Ableton's session view. So let's press Map Select again to return to our regular view. And now these pads are linked with clips in Ableton's session view. And at first sight, it might seem that the first row of pads correspond to first row here in Ableton, and the second row corresponds to the second row here, but it's not the case. Actually, these eight pads are of the same row in Ableton's session view. And right now is corresponds to the first wheel. As you can see, we have a highlighted row over here. And if you want to scroll to the second row, you're going to use this big knob. You can see that the highlighted row moves in Ableton, and also the pad changes color. Yellow means there is a clip there, but it is not playing. Unlit pad means there is not a clip. And if there is a clip and it is playing, then the pad will turn green. If you want to record into a clip, say I want to record into the second row of the first track, I can play that pad once. And there you go. And if you want to record into the second track, you have to arm that track. And there are basically two ways of doing that. One is to simply switch to the second track with this left and right arrow button. And by default, Ableton Live will arm a track upon selection. Some people find themselves unable to get Ableton to arm a selected track. In that case, you might want to right-click on this track arm button and tick arm exclusive. And this should solve most of the problems. And if you still find yourself unable to arm selected track, you might have to create an options.txt file under Ableton Live's installation path. There's an article on how to do that in Ableton's official website, so you might want to check that out. And besides using the left and right arrow button to select an arm track, another way to enable recording into a clip is just pressing an empty clip and press it once more. So actually what is happening here is that by pressing it once, you select that track, and by pressing it again, you record into that clip. So that is a quick tutorial on how to set up the integration between KeyLab Essential and Ableton Live's Session View. I hope you have fun with your KeyLab Essential as much as I do. If this video did help you out, please let me know, and please also subscribe to this channel for more videos coming up. So thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.